Hello students, welcome back. Once again, I am going to teach you today Physical Education, Class 12, Chapter 5. And it is the chapter, the Children and Women in Sports. And here you get all the information related, which things are needed for the children for participating in the sports and which things are needed for the women for participation in the sports. So, let us start for this discussion. First of all, sports participation of women in India. So what is given here, you know very well, there is a gender inequality in India, is strongly evident in every field of life, including sports. And so the government of India instituted the National Sports Festival for Women with the objective to promote women's sports. However, this program could not bring any noticeable improvement in women's participation in sports. So, surveys have shown that women don't participate in sports due to. So, which reasons are there? Why the women are not participating in the sports? So, there are different factors you can see. Number A, constraints are there. Women find less time for sports due to their domestic duties. Women are working at home, so they are not getting enough time for participating in sports. Number two, social constraints. The attitude of the society towards participation of the women in sports is negative. Means society is not looking in the good way for the participation of the women in the sports. Number three, lack of sports infrastructure, specialized coaching centers, training programs, equipment that are suitable for women athletes are not present adequately or properly. So different things are not available for the women. I told you different things are not available properly in our society. That's why women are lagging behind. Next is absence of skill. There are very few female coaches available to develop the skill of the women. Sociological constraints limit the success of the male coaches with the female. So here male coaches are a number, but the female coaches are very few. So female coach, so here the women are not getting proper opportunity for preparing themselves. Next, number E, concerns of the personal safety. Women are more afraid to venture in a male field, and they are concerned more about safety from harassment or exploitation. So women are very prone to harassment, exploitation, and so they are afraid of. Number F, methods to increase women's participation in sports. There are various ways in which women's participation can be increased. So actually here there are some problems. Problems are given 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and the methods to increase women's participation in sports like coaching programs, safety facilities, and these are price availability, affordability and special consideration associated with the physiology is given. So coaching programs, first of all let us read about the coaching programs. Women should be encouraged. So what is given in these points? Coaching programs, this is the method to increase women's participation in sports. You know very well coaching programs are very less. So women should be encouraged and provided with the opportunity to undertake leadership position within the organization. They should be given privilege for the leadership in the sports, and they should be provided with good technical instructions. They must be given positive, encouraging and instructive feedback. In this way, women should come forward and participate in the sports. Next is safety. Safety matters should be taken carefully. Community sports facilities should be provided with separate location for women. In order to see the safety of the women, you have to arrange the program separately. Facilities. Here, changing facilities must be provided that take into account women's and girls' hygiene needs. You have to see the health and hygiene matter also in the sports for the women. We must ensure that all the areas are easily accessible to girls and their parents. So there should not be any objection that is coming from the parent side or from the girl side, price or affordability. So here participation fees in sports should be reduced or abolished for women, should not be taken. In this way, women should come forward and participate in a number of ways. Concession for the traveling also should be given. Boarding facilities should be provided to the women. And here this point is told, a special consideration associated with the physiology, and here special care should be taken by the sportswoman because of the problems associated with the physiology. Now the points are given. Problems faced by the women during their life are, which are the problems? Actually, there are various problems the women had to go through, and these are like the menarche problem, menstrual dysfunction problem, female athlete triad. These are the problems. So what is menarche? Menarche is a girl's first menstrual period, and it can happen as early from 9 to 15 age, and during this time girls feel tense and emotional. So special attention should be given about this matter. And next point is given, menstrual dysfunction. Here long distance running and other sports may lead to the alteration in the androgen, estrogen and progesterone hormone. In this way, what happened, which is some women may directly or indirectly result in, means amenorrhea, means absence of the menstrual period, or infertility. So infertility will be increased, so lots of problem will come due to the participation of in the sports for the women. And female athlete triad, what is this? The female here the female athlete triad is a syndrome of three related conditions generally seen in teenage or adult female athletes who are not meeting their energy requirements. Some women are not getting energy requirement, they are facing this problem, which ultimately leaves them undernourished, and in this way health will be degraded, and this also affects their performance severely. And here three components for the female athlete triad include, which are the three components for the female athlete triad include. Number one, that is osteoporosis, amenorrhea and eating disorder. So here first number one point, osteoporosis, it is a condition in which bones become weak and brittle, means bone become weak and anytime any damage can be done. And next point, amenorrhea, so it is the absence of the menstrual period that can happen for many reasons. Main causes are genetic abnormalities, excessive exercise or extreme physical or psychological stress. Eating disorder, what does it mean? It refers to either eating in excessive amounts or eating very little. So eating disorder can be happened from the both side, either eating much or eating less. So disorder is related to the mental illness that and affects a person's physical and mental health. A female athlete can have one, two or three parts of the triad. Now psychological aspects of women athletes. Psychological aspects of women athletes are discussed below. So number one, stress. Number two, aggression. Number three, sensitive, eager to learn, and coping. Coping, what is coping? Women are able to handle or managing their emotional or interpersonal problems in a more effective way. So women only can handle themselves with these things, and this helps the women athletes to make strategies for better performance. If they control these things, then they can perform in the better way. Eager to learn means learning curiosity to learn the various things. Sensitive, women are more sensitive to the reaction of the people towards them, so they are very sensitive. And aggression, women may experience aggression that may reduce their performance in sports. And stress is there. All women athletes undergo various degrees of stress due to increased competition and male domination. So in this way, coming into the competition, women are facing a lot of stress. So these are the psychological aspects of women athletes. And now sociological aspects of the sports participation, like it is number one is social stigma is given, number two safety issues, lack of proper facilities. Social stigma, what is told here, the social outlook is that the girls are feeble means very weak, and weak as compared to men. So men are having power but women are not having power. This is the social feedback, and therefore they should not participate in sports. That's why the people of the society are telling the women should not participate in the sports. This is the social stigma. Safety issues, girls have to face certain safety issues such as late night training, going to and coming from sports venues and coaching centers, etc. Due to this, they find difficult to pursue sports. So women cannot do all these things very easily. Lack of proper facilities, women have to face lack of specific facilities as such as separate changing rooms, restroom, etc. They should be provided, but right now they are lacking. Now other problems are there, sociological problems, lack of role models. In the absence of women's greater participation in the sports, there are no role models. As women are coming very less in the sports, so who will be the role model? There is no role model. Due to this, girls do not get encouragement from the parents or coaches, and they are just moving backward. And the less media coverage, media also not interested to take the coverage of the girls or the women's sports activities. So in this way, women are discouraged. Now students, I'm going to tell about the children and sports. So women and sports was over, and now I'm going to discuss about children and sports. There are different perspectives are there for the children and sports. Like number one, motor development. Here in this key points given motor development. So motor development refers to the development, generally body control. So it is the body control development, fine motor skills and large muscle movement also there. Motor skill and large muscle movement also done by the motor development. There are three stages for the motor developments in the children as given infancy. So three stages of development of the motor. So which are the three stages of motor development? Like infancy means very little age, then early childhood, then later childhood. All these are covering up the childhood stage. So three stages of childhood, like infancy, early childhood, later childhood. Motor developments are of two types, like gross motor development and fine motor development. What is gross motor development? Gross motor development involves development of large muscles in the child's body, such as sitting, walking and running. Involves development of the large muscles. So if large muscles are developed in the child's body, such as the sitting, walking, running, these are. Fine motor development involves development of small muscles. So here gross motor development for the large muscles and fine motor development for the small muscles of the body, especially during the small movement of the fingers, hand movement, holding the javelin, discus throw, pole throw, catching and cricket ball, etc. Catching a cricket ball, etc. So you understood us, hopefully. Now that divisions are given, you can see motor development. This is the motor development. It is divided into two parts, gross motor development and fine motor development. So gross motor development for large muscles, you can see it is for the large muscle and it is for the small muscle movements. So here small muscle like finger muscle, toes muscle, eyes, ears, and here sitting, these large muscles are used for sitting, standing, walking, running, jumping, and here painting, writing and cutting. Now, students, I'm just going to teach you about the factors affecting motor development. Factors affecting motor development. Number one, nutrition. Number two, immunization. Number three, environment. So, factors affecting motor development. Number one, nutrition. You know very well, nutritious food promotes good motor development. If you are eating nutritious food, then your motor development will be good. Means small muscle and big muscle development will be good also. And sensory motor development is dependent upon the nutrition that child gets to a great extent. Children get stronger and development good if they get nutritious food. What is immunizations? If mother and child both are immunized at a proper time, it leads to a good sensory motor development. So good nutrition level to mother as well as to the child leads to a good motor development. Environment encouragements, which are environment? Like environment means encouragement, love, security, all these things should be given to the children so that they should come up with their skills in the sports. Now I'm going to tell you about the factors affecting motor development. Which factors affecting motor development? List of things are given, like heredity, nutrition, sleep, immunization, environment, stimulation and interactions, opportunities, training and practice, recreations, education, learning and productivity, gender, posture deformities, sensory impairment, obesity, social skills, mental health. Now this is the point, physical and physiological benefits. Physical and physiological benefits of exercise on children. Physical benefits of exercise. Now this is the point, physical exercise, physical benefits of exercise. So why should children do exercise? What is the benefit? There is obvious some physical benefits. Number one, physical health and strength. Number two, mental health will be strong, emotional well-being, internal in the behavior, internal emotions will be good also. Social health, health will be well, positive school environment, motivating personality, controls antisocial behavior in this way. Now physiological benefits of the exercise, like strengthening the heart, strengthens bones and muscles. Number three, controls blood sugar, regulate blood pressure, increase energy level, and detoxification, reduce cholesterol level. Now I'm going to speak about the advantage and disadvantage of the weight training. So here these two points are given, but here list of items are given for the here list of items, advantage of the weight training and disadvantage of the weight training. So weight training means that you have seen in the gym also, for some people are just taking up the weights. Here, advantage of the weight training, increase bone density. So if you are just lifting any weight, that means you are increasing your bone density, and helps in getting good shape. What does it mean? Weight training is magical as it shape up all the involving appropriate schedule. Fat people can become slim, and slim can gain weight and become strong. So in this way, balancing body will be gained by weight lifting. Those who are slim can be fat, and those who are fat can be slim. In this way, average body condition can be provided by the weight training. Disadvantage of the weight training are risks or injuries. So sometimes you get injuries, sometimes some problems will occur for this. And less flexibility, weight training reduces flexibility, your body flexibility will be reduced. If flexibility exercises are not done along with the weight training, so if you are going to gym and not doing some exercises for the body flexibility, then your body will be there will be no flexibility in your body. If flexibility exercises are done continuously, then such disadvantages can be ignored. So how should you avoid your less flexibility? By doing exercise. Now list of advantages are given for the weight training. Improves posture and range of motion, increases muscle strength, bone density and endurance, means tolerance power, protection against injury, improve motor performances, promote healthy blood pressure and cholesterol levels, maintain healthy weight, develop confidence and self-esteem, improve immune system and functions, improve psycho-socio well-being, promote and develop exercise habits. Now, I'm just telling you the disadvantages of weight training in details given, like maturity problem, introduce injury, maturity problem, injury will be there, safety is less in the weightlifting, and loss of flexibility. You can lose your flexibility if you don't do exercises. What is posture? Now, concept of posture is given. The posture in which the body, posture means position of body, position of body, posture in which the body is so balanced as to produce least fatigue. Fatigue means tiredness. Your body is so balanced that you are less tired. That means balancing the body in accurate and proper manner while sitting, standing, etc., or during any other actions. That means you are instructed, advised, you have read in the various times that you have to sit in the proper manner, you have to stand in the proper manner, so that your body balance would be proper and you will be less tired. Importance of posture. One's personality can be judged if one maintaining the good posture, then his or her personality can be judged. Next is better balance, agility and overall physical performance. Helps in maintaining proper manner of standing, sitting, walking of one's body. It is the measure of one's alertness. Hence, better alignment. This also give you better alignment, which translates into less injury, recovery quicker from the exercises or physical exertion, and feels more energetic. Now, causes of poor posture. Which are the causes for the poor posture? Like injury when bone or ligament or muscle is injured, it weakens and supports that. So if you want to stand properly, cannot stand because you have ligament problem, muscle problem, bones problem, that time you cannot maintain good posture. Disease causes joints or lose their strength or mobility. Sometimes your knee joints or leg joints are not working properly, that time you cannot maintain your good posture. Hereditary deformities like kyphosis and flat foot are sometimes due to the hereditary factors. Overwork or fatigue also results poor posture. Sometimes people become tired, so much tired they cannot control their good posture. Lack of exercise, the maintenance effects of posture requirements strength and endurance. Common postural deformities. Which are the common postural deformities? Postural deformities are the exaggerated curvature of the spine. Sometimes spine can be curved. So this is the deformed or not in the proper formation. The spine is naturally curved, but various factors may give rise to the deformities. It reduces the efficiency of the individual to get to great extent and cause more health problem. So if you are suffering from bad postural problem, that time you have to suffer a lot for this. So there are different types of postural deformities. Number one, knock knee. Number two, flat foot, round shoulders, like kyphosis. I will explain one by one. Knock knee. What is knock knee? Knock knee is a postural deformity in which both the knees touch and overlap each other in normal standing position. If your both the knees are touching each other, So this is the deformity, weakness of muscles and ligaments, overweight body, lack of balanced diet. So causes for the knock knee. So if your knees are joined together, that means you have overweight, you have lack of balanced diet, you have lack of vitamin D, all this. Flat foot. What is called flat foot? Flat foot is a deformity of the feet. It is related to the feet. In this deformity, there is no arch in the foot and the foot is completely flat. If your foot is completely flat, that means your foot is known as flat foot. Instead of like this, this is the arch shape. If your feet is like this flat totally, that means you have flat foot. Round shoulder, what does it mean? It is a postural deformity in which the shoulders are drawn, the head is extended with the chin pointing forward. Means your shoulder is not standing in proper position and your head is extended with the chin pointing forward. So if your head is coming down and shoulder is not in upright, that means you have round shoulder. So due to poor posture while walking or faulty furniture or wrong habit of sitting and standing causes this, and carry heavy loads on shoulders. So if you are carrying heavy loads on your shoulders, that time your shoulders go down by slipping on one side. This can happen also. Next point, kyphosis. Kyphosis is a deformity of spine in which there is an increase or exaggeration of the backward curve, correlative measures of the kyphosis. So kyphosis is a deformity of the spine. It is related to the spine in which there is an increase or exaggerated. Increase means exaggerated. So increase of the backward curve. So like perform. So if you have kyphosis problem, then you can practice Dhanurasana regularly. Bend your head backward. Bend your so these are, I'm telling about the corrective measures. How can you cure this kyphosis? Bend your head backward in standing position. Another measures are there for kyphosis, like reverse sit up. You are generally giving forward sit up, but if you are giving reverse sit up, that means opposite sit up, that will help you. Perform Bhujangasana. So if you are performing Bhujangasana, then you will be cured. Like another asana is perform Ustasana, and bow legs is a deformity opposite knock knee. So bow legs is, this is the bow leg is a deformity opposite knock knee. And in fact if there is a wide gap between the knees, the deformity can be observed easily. So it is your knee and it is your knee, so there is no touching. If there is a gap in this way, this is a deformity. Now telling about lordosis, is a common defect or deformity or posture. Here lumbar curve becomes more pronounced and front central position of the pelvic region is tilted forward. So what is the corrective measures for the lordosis? The forward bending, alternate toe touching, sloop walking, perform paschimottanasana, perform sit-ups regularly. Now given causes of scoliosis. Causes of scoliosis. So congenital scoliosis, degenerative scoliosis, idiopathic scoliosis. There are three types of scoliosis. So congenital scoliosis, which is caused by the bone abnormality present at birth. It is a bone abnormality present at the birth. Neuromuscular scoliosis. Neuromuscular scoliosis, which results clue to low abnormal muscles or nerves. This is seen in people with cerebral palsy, means head problem, and having partial paralysis. So this type of problem can have partial paralysis, little paralysis, and degenerative scoliosis, which may result from the traumatic or injury, illness, bone collapse, previous major back surgery, or osteoporosis. Here, idiopathic scoliosis, which is the most common type, it has no specific identifiable cause. So here, it is a very common idiopathic. It is very common. So it is no specific identification cause. You cannot identify it properly. So preventive measures to avoid scoliosis. How to prevent all the scoliosis? Corrective measures of the scoliosis: perform Ardha Chakrasana, chin ups. Number 3, swim by using breaststroke technique. Perform Trikonasana, perform Tarasana. In this way, you can cure this different scoliosis like congenital, degenerative, and idiopathic. All these were related to this chapter 5, children and women sports. So this chapter has been totally given in the YouTube, and hopefully you will get all the valuable tips, and the same note has been provided to you for reading purpose. Learn all this, get ready for the board. Now I will come after the puja vacation. Till then, goodbye to all of you.